So that's so go ahead and you'll be safer with a smaller inventory overhang. By safe, we mean nothing goes wrong with your property, but simply that at least you will not see a big dip in prices immediately or in the coming few months. All right, list of things to check, Arpan, is something that you'd also asked for. So this is it. Documents to check before buying an under construction property. You should confirm whether it has approved building plans from appropriate authority. Those should be in place. You should also check if the developer has obtained necessary permissions and NOCs from various authorities. So these could be your environment clearance, height clearance, etc. You should also verify the title certificate to make sure land title is clear and there is no litigation on the project land. And of course, make sure that the builder has intimation of disapproval. That's an IOD and commencement certificate, CC, to start construction. And we always, of course, this is, we are not talking about pre-launch, so I'm going to leave that out. But last but not the least, get the agreement evaluated by an advocate. Write to us. We do know a lot of good advocates and we'll be happy to help you. All right, Madhur Bhatia on the phone line with us. Madhur, hi, go ahead. How can we help you?
Hi, my budget is in 60 to 70 lakh range and I'm looking for a property in and around Navi Mumbai basically. So mainly Lodha, Palava. I was looking for in Kasabela and another one is Khargar sector 34, 35 in this range which I'm getting. Okay. And my working location is Powai. So based on that, I just wanted to know that which one is a better option. Lodha Palava is something which I was looking forward for.
Well, Lodha Palava is of course a good project, a very, very vast project. So it's coming up in phases, Sameer. And the good part is that it is going to be a smart city. It's one of the rare first few projects in India. Because of its size, it can be technically, technologically integrated and acquire the shape of what a full smart city could be in the future.
Sure. Yes, you're absolutely right. Although Pallava city is not in Navi Mumbai, it's in Dombivli region, which is a part of Thane. So we've got Khargar also as a micro market for you and also Thane as well, which is Dombivli. You can go ahead with the project. There are multiple projects inside the Lodha Pallava city. The one that we've shortlisted for you are is Casa Sophistica, which is at 6200 rupees a square foot, available in the resale market. As I mentioned, this is a part of the 4,500 acre township, of which 2,200 acres of land is already under development. Amenities like 100 acres of central park, 9-hole golf course, Olympic size sports stadium. This is as big as it gets in terms of amenities. 100 acres land for a proposed university. Sophistica is also adjoining the Lodha World School and Xperia Mall on the Kalyan Shilpata Road. And coming to some key data points of both Dombivli and Khargar. Khargar is one of our favorite micro markets where social infrastructure is quite well in place, but the connectivity to other parts is just fantastic. Dombivli East is at 5,800 rupees a square foot on the weighted average price chart with a safe inventory overhang of 70 months. And Khargar is even better at 7,900 rupees in terms of weighted average price, but inventory overhang is 15 odd months. On the price appreciation front, Khargar is doing probably the best, 11.2% on an annualized basis, followed by Dombivli East at 10 odd percent. The two projects in Khargar that you can consider are Sumukha by Sai Developers at 6,550 rupees a square foot. This project is only 900 meters away from the proposed Sector 34 metro station. Project is only 1.2 kilometers from the Central Park and Golf Course. It has basic amenities only. And then we have Arihant Annaya by Arihant Superstructures at 7,800 to 8,000 rupees a square foot. This project is within 1 kilometer from the Central Park and Golf Course. Well-developed social infrastructure is quite in the vicinity, 700 meters from the proposed Sector 34 metro station, and it's connecting to all the key areas which are not very far away as well. It was completed in 2010, fully inhabited with modern amenities.
All right, so here's a quick summary of what else you can look at in that budget. Arihant Annaya, Arihant Superstructures, and Sumukha by Sai Developers. Moving on, the majority of buildings in Mumbai are over 50 years old and in dire need of redevelopment. But most of the time, redevelopment plans don't really take off due to differences with the builder or among society members themselves. This is where self-redevelopment comes in, a way for societies to become the developer of their own societies. How does this work and how feasible is this model? Ashwini has this report.
This seven-story building in Borivali did not look like this a few years ago. In its place was an old dilapidated building which was in need of repair. After several failed negotiations with various builders, the society members decided to redevelop it themselves.
Builder was were not willing to proceed also. Then we thought it is better, society's condition is very bad, dilapidated condition, that is why better to go with the loan, mortgage the property and go for self-development.
This model of self-development is becoming a popular option for societies across Mumbai. Here, societies apply for loans to redevelop their housing complex and appoint a contractor to carry out the redevelopment to their specifications. No builders are involved and the society gets access to all the benefits including extra FSI and TDR. Each member gets at least 35 to 45% extra area and the society is less dependent on the builder. The homeowners can also be more sure of timely completion of the project, while additional flats can be sold to buyers of the own choice. Income tax will also be not applicable, thereby profits will remain within the society and would substantially reduce maintenance cost.
If the societies go for self-redevelopment, I would definitely say that they will get double the area what is promised by the developer.
Today, Mumbai District Central Cooperative Bank gives loans of up to 85% that covers the project cost for which buyers mortgage their land. Other banks are considering this policy and might implement it in near future. This bank also provides good professional help to assist in the process of construction.
We are having our own CA, we are having our own architect, we are having our PMC also. So that they can go to the society and they can explain what is the self-redevelopment and how benefit you will get.
Self-redevelopment has the potential to change the face of redevelopment in Mumbai and can ensure that homeowners are not left at the mercy of builders. But builder lobbies claim the method is not without its risks.
You need to deal with many departments, that's one. Secondly, not necessary that all the society member or couple of them have the expertise or that much enough adequate time to go and approach various agencies, appoint various consultants.
While that may be true, self-redevelopment holds out hope for those societies which have not been going in for redevelopment in the fear of being taken advantage of by builders. And if executed well, there is no reason why this cannot be a viable method to redevelop the many dilapidated societies in Mumbai. With Ashwini Priyolkar in Mumbai, this is Sharon Alex for NDTV.
Well, do it yourself is hard, sometimes more profitable, but it could be full of challenges as well. On the other side, exclusive story on MMRDA's plans to change Wadala skyline. That's an exclusive here on The Property Show. And also the spotlight on top residential markets of Pune and Ahmedabad. And of course, on your screen, as we slip into a break, our project tracker this week is Arihant Anshula. Check out what the project is offering.